Try to get up, Homer.
I can't.
Too bad, man.
Why, you little...
Crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
Wait, don't throw away those old one-color portables. Use them as sunblock or whisk away unsightly poop. This environmental moment brought to you by Game Gear, the full-color portable with tons of new games.
All right, you can hear the chants of USA in the background, and that can't be a popular chant with World Television Champion Lord Steven Regal, apparently.
Why on earth are you here? Last week, I demanded that I have a public apology off that Zbyszko chappy. I want him here right now, and I want my apology.
Oh, wait a minute.
I'm not going anywhere till I get it. Get him out.
What do you think? You're playing with chopped liver, pal? This is my job. I want to tell you the truth. Lord Regal, I have made arrangements. I've got Larry Zbyszko standing by. I'm going to ask the living legend from Pittsburgh to join us, if he would. Here he comes. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the all-time greats and a man, of course, who has joined us beyond the microphones as of late, Larry Zbyszko. Larry, these gentlemen feel that they're owed an apology by you.
You know, I understand we have a problem here. Let me make one thing clear. I am here only because of the request made by Mr. Okerlund. But we will clear some things up. Look, I'm not a very apologetic type of guy. Okay? Once in a blue moon, I apologize to the wife only so I can live happily ever after. But I'm not apologizing to you. I'm not here to apologize to you. Okay, we're going to clear it up. I'm not going to interview you anymore. I don't need the aggravation. Good luck, Gene.
All right, thank you very much, Libby. Hey, you don't just...
You better be apologizing to his lordship. You better be apologizing.
I'm not here to hit anybody.
Oh, my God, he's walking. Hey. Oh, what is this? Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Zbyszko. Steven Regal right off his back.
Get up, you bloody fool. Get up.
And stay tuned. We're going to be back with more Saturday Night after this. Try sort this out, Heenan. All right, folks, welcome back to more Saturday Night here on TBS. Joining me at this time, World Television champ, a little worse for wear, Lord Steven Regal, along with his associate, Sir William. Last week, you took it on the chin, my friend.
On the chin? What kind of a legend does he call himself, striking a gentleman's gentleman? I'm just a trainer of the world.
Whoa,
but I'm quite adverse
to... Shut up! All you took was a mere slap on the face. I, on the other hand, had my clothes torn off my body barbarically by Zbyszko.
You were lucky to get out of there with even your shorts on. I mean, he stripped you.
Back in my grandfather's days, for his barbaric actions, he would have been beheaded and tortured in the Bloody Tower, and then his family would have been deported to Australia. But in this country where vileness rules, there is no law and order, and there is a complete lack of respect for nobility. So I have to take things into my own hands, and I demand satisfaction. I demand that fall in the ring with me. And there's no other way to it. I demand a match with you, Zbyszko, you out-of-shape old has-been. You so-called legend, I'm going to prove that you were nothing that you never was. And you, do you have anything to say about it?
Well, I think you've just about taken everything away that I could possibly say. You've shocked me. I can't believe it. Asking for Larry Zbyszko, World Television Champion, Lord Steven Regal. Not in a real good frame of mind. Let's get back up to the ring. I've got a good hunch. I know who that patriot is. I do know who this man is. He is the living legend, Larry Zbyszko. Larry, last week in front of a national television audience right here, Lord Steven Regal came out, and, well, I got to say, you really dressed this guy down.
You know something? It's been giving me a very big problem, Gene. You know, it's amazing how history repeats itself. You know, a little more than 200 glorious years ago, an English man named General Cornwallis stepped into the ring wearing a bright red jacket. And across the ring from him was a great American fighter. His name was George Washington. Now, we don't have to go into any details, but after George Washington hooked General Cornwallis in the abdominal stretch, the good general gave up and ran all the way back to England, crying the blues with his little band of merry men with his red coat tucked between his legs. Henceforth, this country arose after that and became the most powerful, the most advanced, and the most generous country on the face of the planet. It gave rise to entrepreneur geniuses like Ted Turner, who took the technology of the microchip and turned telecommunications worldwide via satellite. It made the planet, Gene, a very small place, and henceforth, my problem. What do I do?
Are you going to be facing Lord Stephen Regal? He wants you.
What do I do? Where's my problem? Okay. Do I walk around the world my entire life being known as Larry Zbyszko, a legendary wrestler, or do I walk through the world being known as a coward who ran away from Lord Stinkin' Regal? I'm sorry. Freudian slip.
Yeah.
Well, you know something, Regal? I'm going to be honest with you. I can't wait to step into Philadelphia with you. I can't wait to show you that unlike the majority of the people in this country who are generous, loving people, I'm not a nice guy. For 18 glorious years, I've shut my big mouth off worldwide. I've retired legends. I've achieved my dream twice, and I've done it because of two reasons. Number one, I had the freedom here to do it. And number two, nobody's been good enough to come along and shut my mouth. So in Philadelphia, you take your best shot. And I'll see you in Larryland, you pompous jerk.
All right, I thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Things are heating up to slammery next Sunday night in Philadelphia. Stay tuned, we're going to be right back. Fans, tomorrow night at Slamboree, a Legends reunion, live on pay-per-view. Call your local cable company now to be part of the action that gets underway at 7 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time. One of the great matches on this spectacular card in Philadelphia pits world television champion Lord Stephen Regal against the living legend Larry Zbyszko. Sometime back, Zbyszko walked away during an interview he was conducting with his lordship. Regal took exception. Let's go to the footage.
Here we have a draft dodger, never went to war, and yet you people treat him as some kind of hero. Absolutely pathetic. And now, you idiots, you fools, give millions and billions of dollars to the Russians, and they spy on you. You're all fools.
That's it. Look it, your lordship, I just paid enough income tax to build housing for the homeless people. I can say whatever I want about this country because I bought the right. As far as I'm concerned, you can just shut up. Just shut up. I hope Flying Brian breaks your neck. Here, I don't need this. I'm not a very apologetic type of guy, okay? Once in a blue moon, I apologize to the wife only so I can live happily ever after. But I'm not apologizing to you. I'm not here to apologize to you. Okay, we're gonna clear it up. I'm not going to interview you anymore. I don't need the aggravation. Good luck, Gene.
All right, thank you very much, Libby. Hey, you don't just...
You better be apologizing to his lordship. You better be apologizing.
I'm not here to hit anybody.
Tomorrow night in Philadelphia, the only town in America that has ever heard of you, I'm going to expose you, Mr. Zbyszko, for being a no-good, nosy, two-bit pretense of a wrestler. You were once something a long time ago. Now you're an out-of-shape has-been. You don't seem to be able to accept the fact. Tomorrow night, I'm going to prove to you and Philadelphia that you're just like America, stupid, unintelligent, and worthless.
You know, I understand you're doing a lot of research on me, your lordship, preparing for the match of a lifetime. I am going to show you tomorrow night exactly what makes up a great Matt technician. I'm not royalty, your worship. I'm just a Polack from the hills of Pennsylvania who is going to take you in front of everybody and give you the wrestling lesson of your miserable little life.
Tomorrow night in Philadelphia, world television champ Lord Steven Regal defends against the living legend Larry Zbyszko. Call your cable company now regarding availability. I'll have more on Slamboree, a Legends reunion, when we return here on Saturday night. Don't go away.
McDonald's takes you back to bedrock.
Fellow Lodge members, introducing one that is truly unique, one of extraordinary appeal, the Grand Poobah Supersized Meal at McDonald's.
A juicy McRib sandwich
smothered in tangy sauce with supersized fries and a large Coke.
Last one of McDonald's is a fossil!
Grand Poobah meals for everyone!
Order! Order!
You're such Neanderthals.
Mm-hmm. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Flash out. Toss it, lob it, throw it. Just don't get caught with it. Just fill the balloon with water, set the timer, then get rid of it. Because when time runs out, you get wet. Splash out from Gloob. Water not included.
We biker mice were cruising when I smelled trouble. Lawrence Limburger. Yo, cheese breath. Catch this. Nice face. Yeah. Time to rock and ride.
Biker mice from Mars. Bikes and figures each sold separately.
Before Nintendo came out with Super Metroid, we wanted to make sure it was the most intense Metroid battle ever. So we thought we'd see how Killer here would fare against it. Ready, boy? That's 24 megs worth of weapons, worlds, and weirdos old Killer's up against. Nintendo's biggest game ever. But he's a big boy. He can handle it. Well, let's see how he did. Ship it! Super Metroid, only on the Super NES.
Fans, as we left you last week, Lord Steven Regal, Larry Zbyszko embattled in a world television title matchup. We had to leave you before the match ended. Let's show you some of what happened last week right here on TBS. Great timing of Larry.
But he's got six different holds on him. You call it.
What you call stretching a match. Ah, that old reverse standing surfboard.
That's not the first man Zbyszko stretch. Won't be the last.
One, two, three. Elbow to the gut. But Zbyszko caught the foot. Little leg pick up now.
Uh-oh.
Standing reverse figure four coming here. He's got it.
I've never seen this hold used. This is a standing figure four.
A standing reverse figure four.
Oh, reverse. Yes, I've seen this before. You didn't say reverse. See, Zbyszko's reverse. Regal's got reverse. That's what you mean.
He's got Zbyszko down. Two count. We are now less than 2 minutes to go in this television program, and the battle goes on.
Doesn't go in Zbyszko, does it?
The fans will remind you again as we get a cover here. But wait a minute, he's in the ropes. That will not stop the match. The match will continue, possibly. If they do not end the match within the next minute and a half, the tape machines will be rolling, and we'll show you the conclusion of the match next week. But right now, with about a minute and a half to go, Regal assaulting Zbyszko.
Well, what's the time limit on this match, Shivani?
I think it was about a 1 hour and 30 minutes.
I've got things to do. This is... Zorro beat up that guy from a fish and chip store. I got things to do.
Here's a cover from Regal again. What a mess. The
he
foot's
got
on
it,
the
got
result.
It,
foot is on the ropes. You see it right there. And he's still.
Please, let's break the foot off then and cover him. I got things to do.
A reversal. Zbyszko holds his ground. Whoa, the foot.
Cover him. Hook him.
And a chance.
This is it.
He telegraphed him, but still on contact. Didn't hook a leg. And Zbyszko rolls to his right to get out of it. And again.
Come on, pin him.
I'm told now 30 seconds to go. One, two. Fans, there is no main event tomorrow night. But there will be a Saturday night program next week, 1 hour, as we are down in the waning moments of this television program.
Somebody win, I don't care who, I got things to do.
10 seconds to go, join us next week as we will show you the conclusion, how it happened between Zbyszko and Lord Steven Regal.
Wait a minute, I got things to do.
We're out of time. All right, fans, that happened last week, and when we come back from the break, Gene, we're going to show the fans the conclusion of the World TV title matchup.
You know, I got to tell you something, Cody. I'm really impressed with the endurance, the stamina, and certainly the technique of this great master, this technician, Larry Zbyszko. I got to tell you, I'm impressed. We're going to see that matchup, the conclusion, when we return here on TBS.
Well, our television show has just gone off the air, and I don't know how much we're going to be able to show our fans on WCW Saturday Night. But we're going to keep commentating the match here, and I tell you what, Zbyszko coming right after Regal break.
I'll tell you something, knowing Larry Zbyszko like I do, we may be here a couple weeks. He wants that title. He wants it bad.
Regal.
And Regal wants to hold on to that title. That's very important to him.
This has been a classic matchup between two of the greats in our four-side headlock. Near side rope. Both go down.
This could be a draw, too.
It really could.
His lordship's going to get up. He's in better shape than Zbyszko is.
One, two. We got a two count. Two count again. Regal goes back to the well a third time. Zbyszko keeps fighting out.
Instead of going to the well, he better go get some petrol. That needle's on E.
Repeated cover and an uppercut on Zbyszko, sending Zbyszko in.
Here we are.
The sleeper hold is out.
Ring the bell. It's over.
Wait a minute. He pushes Sir William down. Zbyszko covers it. He beat it.
And champ, Larry Zbyszko, the steel man from the steel city. Oh, my.
You know, Gene, if you had asked me 3 months ago if I would have been back into the ring, I would have thought you were nuts. You know, and Regal kept shooting off his mouth and shooting off his mouth about me, about the country. All I got to say is this. I did it, your lordship. I did it. It's for me, and it's for each one of these people that you go out of your way to insult. Tell you something, next time you come out here and you talk about Larry Zbyszko and you talk about the United States of America, you do it with some respect.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've got a brand new world television champion. He is Larry Zbyszko.
Welcome to the Fleer Ultra Baseball Factory Tour. This year, we're putting gold foil stamping on both sides. Plus, more color-enhanced action on our all-new three-photo bags.
Fasten your seatbelts.
Yeah! There's UV coating on both sides, too. And we're in your face with incredible inserts featuring superstars and hot rookies. There's one insert card in every pack. 94 Fleer Ultra Baseball, better than ever.
Hey, we at Sega Sports are pretty happy about the response to our new sports pack. One comes with a Genesis. NFL 94, two controllers, and a seat cushion. Or get one with a Game Gear, a deluxe carry-all bag, and World Series Baseball. Or pick one with a Sega CD and Joe Montana's NFL football. And all three sports packs are specially priced, but they're only making a limited number. So you better get yours before things get ugly.
All right, fans, welcome back to TBS, WCW Saturday Night on this historic night here on TBS. And fans, Clash of the Champions upcoming.
Thursday, June 23rd, one match for the World Television title. The champion, Larry Zbyszko, the legend, defending against the man you defeated for the belt, Larry, or Steven Regal.
You know, obviously, Lord Regal is not up on all his American traditions yet. We're going to have to enlighten the man a little farther. You know, we've got one here called freedom of speech, Your Lordship. A lot of people take it for granted. A lot of people died for the right. And through that freedom of speech we have here in America, I have been called many names over the years, some we won't get into. One name, however, I've never been called, and that's a coward. You gave me an opportunity to take your world championship belt. Well, I'm man enough to extend the same courtesy. I'm going to give you a chance to get back in the ring with me and prove that you're a great mat technician. Obviously, Tony, he's not great enough. We're going to find out who the greatest mat technician of all times is at the Clash of Champions. You know, let's talk about one more American tradition. You love this one. It's called baseball. Personally, I think it's great for insomnia. But there's one great cliche that has emerged from that game, Your Lordship, and it's three strikes, you're out of here. I've already beaten you twice. Third time's the charm.
The World Television Champion Larry Zbyszko as we go to the ring.
And this coming Thursday night live right here on TBS at 8:05 at the Clash of the Champions, World Television Champion Larry Zbyszko is going to be locking up one more time with his, well, his royalness, his nobleness, Lord Steven Regal.
My royal foe, mean one.
A royal pain in the...
Yeah, you know what. You know, we've been enlightening his lordship on American traditions. There's one, however, I kept till the very end. We don't want Lord Regal to know too much. But let's point out one thing about America. You don't know Lord Regal, and I do. And that is the most beautiful catch 22 in the history of the planet, which gives Americans a license to do whatever they want, which means that the Clash of Champions, I can get in the ring with you and do anything I want legally as long as you are temporarily insane.
My.
You ask anybody that knows me, Your Worship, and I'm still crazy after all these glorious years. So you take that free one-way ticket to Larryland and give it your best shot. Like we said before, this is America. Three strikes, you're out of here.
All right, this Thursday night at the Clash of the Champions, Larry Zbyszko, World Television Champ, meets Lord Steven Regal right here live on TBS.